Many of you here today will be new to Project Haystack, and no doubt you've all got a lot to learn. So I'm here to tell you that Project Haystack is evolving. Haystack is continually expanding, growing, and refining itself. And it is not defined by a couple of stuffy professors in a cupboard either. No, Project Haystack is defined by people, and Project Haystack is defined by people like you and people like me. It is an open standard that we can all have a say in. I'm going to give you a sneak preview of the latest Haystack version, that's version 4, and explain why it is a big step in machine intelligence. But first, why should you listen to me? Let me introduce myself. Hello, I'm Steve. Pleased to meet you. I'm not a salesman or a business analyst, and I'm not here to sell you anything, but I am just a computer programmer. I write software for Project Haystack, and I like standards like Haystack because it makes my life a lot easier. So I'd like to explain to you why I personally think why it's a great idea and how you can get involved to change the future. But before I can talk about the future, I must first talk about the past. Computer devices, like this one, collect data. They continually sample data from many sensors and many set points, and they do this every few seconds, or every few minutes, all day, every day. In all, these devices collect a lot of data. There are streams and streams of it, and it's never ending. At first glance, you may think, wow, this is great, I'm getting my hands on all this data. But let's take a closer look at it. Can anyone tell me what this data actually is? I'm assuming not. Let me help you out. I'm going to zoom in onto an individual number. There we go, 18. So, what is 18? And therein lies a problem. That's exactly my point. So this is why Project Haystack exists. It lets you add metadata to your actual data. So let's try it with 18. First of all, we're going to assign it a unit, degrees Celsius. Brilliant. Now we know it's a temperature, but a temperature of what? So we tag it with sensor. That's cool. Now we know it's an input. It's measuring something. But what is it measuring? We can tag it with air. Cool, now we know the substance, but air of what? Another tag, air handling unit. Brilliant, it's a device, but these devices are big complicated beasts. So what part of the air handling unit is it? We tag it with discharge. Okay, now we have the output. Now we're getting somewhere, but where is this? Another tag, rooftop. Brilliant, all of a sudden, we're getting a clearer picture and idea of what 18 is all about. So Project Haystack lets you describe what data you have, and this is incredibly important. So someone once asked me, isn't it inefficient to store all these tags with every little bit of data? The answer is of course no, and that is because we don't store all these tags with every little bit of data. We identify the stream of data and we put the tags against that. That way these tags are only defined just the once. But Project Haystack is more than just a tagging standard. Project Haystack is about interoperability between different computer systems. It defines the types of data that can be tagged. We're talking about, you know, dates, times, numbers, booleans, and references and stuff. And if you have a number, Project Haystack also defines the units. So we know if we're talking about square feet, square meters, pascals, degrees Celsius, whatever. But it goes beyond this. When kitting out a building, we're going to have lots of different devices, computers and equipment, all from different vendors. So Project Haystack defines file formats. So your cheap Chinese temperature sensor can seamlessly talk to your gateway. And today's age of Internet of Things, everything is networked. So Project Haystack also defines an Internet REST API. In all, it's all about communication and interoperability, so you can avoid vendor lock-in. So let's have a closer look at these Project Haystack tags. They are all defined on the Project Haystack website. I've taken a couple of screenshots of some of the tag definitions here. We have blowdown at the top. It says it is paired with water to indicate control or measurement. And then we have the water tag, which is a point associated with the measurement or control of water. Now, as a human reading the website, this is a great source of information. I now know about the blowdown tag and that it can be used with the water tag. But as a computer programmer, I have an issue with this. That is because the definitions of these Haystack tags are exactly what you see. English words on a website. There's nothing here that a computer can read and understand. This means that the application of haystack tags is all in the hands of humans, and we humans have a habit of making mistakes. Think about Dave, that poor engineer who's commissioning a new building late on a Friday night. He's entering data for the 42nd new device, but all he's thinking about really is that beer's out with the boys. Now there's a good chance this Dave is going to mix up the leaving tag with the entering tag, and he's going to confuse a pipe with a duct. As a computer programmer, I can actually sanity check all this data and Dave's work, and I can make sure that Dave's on the ball, and I can help him leave the building before the pubs close. I just need to know what data it is I have. And in my eyes, that is what Project Haystack 4 is all about. It's about adding formal, machine-readable definitions to haystack tags so computers can understand more. It's about empowering computers so they can make informed decisions and the computers can do more. It's all about the rise of the machines. Yeah. Okay, so in reality, Project Haystack 4 is not so dramatic, but it does introduce a lot of tag meta and formal definitions around existing haystack tags, so the data models can be more easily understood by software. In particular, I'm going to explain a little more about the concepts of naming, classification, and relationships. First up, naming. Everybody here today is talking about tags, tags, and tags. And yes, Project Haystack does define hundreds of them. There are so many. Even the website has started to group them into separate pages and categories. Some of these categories are shown here, but Project Haystack is expanding and more categories are being added. For example, I'm also part of a working group that's looking at defining tags for cybersecurity. While it's a good thing that Project Haystack is growing and is to encapsulate more and more subject areas, at some point this is going to become problematic. For example, we all understand that the tag hot is going to be related to temperature, probably in degrees Celsius or Fahrenheit or degrees Kelvin. But what if Haystack expands to encompass catering? What if I want to describe how spicy a food is? Well, I may want to create my own hot tag. The problem here is that now I have a conflicting tag name. Hot can either mean temperature hot or it can become spicy hot, depending on the context. Yes, this is a contrived example, but it will become a real problem. So the first thing Project Haystack 4 does is it introduces the concept of a namespace, and it calls these libraries. All tags must belong to a library, and now I can differentiate between the different types of hot. The next thing Project Haystack 4 introduces is a means of classification. In a way, this is where tags are used to describe tags. When we look up a definition of a tag, like water, it points to another tag and says, hey, I'm one of these. So a water is a liquid, is a fluid, is a substance, and so on. It lets us build up a hierarchy that describes what tags are. This means that I only need to tag my data with water. And then I can automatically infer all the other tags from that. Project Haystack 4 is doing two things here. The first is that it gives me a mechanism to describe hierarchies. The second is that it also provides pre-made libraries of common building automation tags and their hierarchies. That way, I have a concrete language that already describes things like water, ice, and air. These hierarchies are an example of an ISA relationship, but Project Haystack 4 goes further. Version 4 gives us a mechanism to describe other relationships between tags and hierarchies. Here we define that a pipe conveys liquid or water. It's an older slide. Note again that Haystack gives us two things, both a mechanism to formally define these relationships and a standard library of building automation terms, and with these relationships already defined. These standard libraries include relationships such as cools, heats, regulates, and ventilates. But the method for defining such relationships is a lot more flexible in Haystack than what you're going to find in other classification systems. So to keep things simple in this talk, I've used the words naming, classification, and relationships. But if you were to look at the official Project Haystack documentation or the other classification systems, you're going to see words like vocabulary, taxonomy, and ontology. Now, these are big words, they're quite unnecessary, and they mean exactly as I have described. So don't be scared by them when you're reading other documentation. I've talked about new formal tag definitions coming in Project Haystack 4, and how computers will understand more about the tags that we already use today. But why bother with all of this? Well, going back to Dangerous Dave, and he's commissioning his building late one Friday evening. Well, we can now more easily validate his work and check for silly mistakes. And all this metadata around tags lets us perform powerful queries. I can now search my building for all equipment that heat air or convey liquids. This gives rise to more intelligent rules for automation and analytics, which in turn could fuel future AI systems. But the important thing for me personally is that I can use these newly defined relationships to start developing more intuitive UI and software. Now, I've been talking about Project Haystack 4, but version 4 isn't officially released yet, although it is under public review. You can read all about it and contribute to the discussions and working groups on the Project Haystack website. Now, version 4 has been undergoing development for almost 2 years now. 2 years, I hear you exclaim. Heavens above, why is it taking them so long? Well, because this guy. As much as we humans love to classify things and put things neatly into the little pigeonholes, classification is hard, and there are always exceptions to the rule. The other reason is that language often works against us. There's a cool feature in version 4 that lets us co-join tags with hyphens, and when we do, we automatically inherit everything from those individual tags. So if we were to tag a piece of data with hot hyphen water, then we can assume that that data is both hot and water, and we can infer all those things that come with the hot tag and the water tag. And this is a great idea, and we can use this a lot. But what of something else? What of site meter? Is it going to work for us? Our survey says, because a site meter may well be a meter, but it is not a site. It is not a building. So in this instance, we have to use a specialist site meter tag. And as you can imagine, all these conflicts and ambiguities spark a lot of opinion and debate, which you'll see on the forums. But Project Haystack 4 is at the later stages of review and should be officially with us very soon. And that's me done. I hope this has stimulated some thought on Project Haystack 4 and explained the direction on where it is now heading. I'm happy to be contacted should you wish to know more, and don't forget you can always review the documentation and the working group discussions on the Project Haystack website itself. I am Steve Einan, and this has been The Rise of the Machines. Thank you, good day.